Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I'm going to teach you how to read and write the letter Aleph and its many varieties. As you can see, this letter appears in different forms. However, you just look at it and you see a vertical line, but it can have different sounds based on the markers. So in this case, for example, we have A, in the other case E, the third one is O, and the last one A. Now, Aleph by itself is also A if it's in the middle or at the end of a word. So here you see a hat on top of Aleph, and this hat appears only when you write a word which starts with the sound A. Otherwise, you don't need to put that hat. Okay, I'm going to actually zoom in and explain to you one by one how each of these cases would work. Let's start with the first possibility, A. So here you see that there is a marker on top of Aleph, and this is not written normally. When you, for example, read a newspaper, you don't see this. This is only used when people go to school, when they're little kids and they're learning the language. So this sound, A, is really similar to the sound A in the English word cat. It's not really that different. So in this case, as you can see, it is written as a vertical line and a marker on top. So we have A, as you can see. Now, remember that when you write your line, you want to actually move your pen from above the line to the line. That's kind of stylistically important. So, let's go to the next possibility. The same letter Aleph, now the marker is below the line. In this case, the sound will be different, will be E. So, this sound is very similar to the sound E in the word bed in English. It's a short vowel. Now, again, the vertical line and the marker below. Remember, these markers are not written. We're just using them here for you to understand why one version of Aleph is pronounced differently from another version of Aleph. Okay, the third version, O. This time, there is a marker on top. It kind of looks like number 9 in English, and the sound is O, as in the English word go. Now, it's a little bit shorter than go, especially it is the sound that you will hear in American English, go. Now, let's actually focus on just another version, which is ah. And in this case, you see that I have written ah with a hat. It's because this ah will appear at the beginning of a word. The sound is like A in the English word car, so it's a long vowel, A. And again, Aleph can appear in the middle or at the end, and it does not need a hat, but if it's at the beginning of a word, it will need that hat. For example, when we write the word ab, because Aleph, the sound A, is at the beginning, we put that hat on top of Aleph, ab. But if any other word, if it's not at the beginning, we will not put that hat on top of Aleph. Okay. Let's practice this a little bit more. So, we learned A, and I'm going to write down some examples for you. E. For A, we have an example like abr, abr, which means cloud. Now, as you can see, abr, the first letter, the first alif with the marker on top, is pronounced as A. And remember that we are reading and writing from right to left. The second case, the example, is a little bit more complicated. It is the word امشب. امشب. Now, you are already familiar with a couple of these letters here. امشب. You already know به, you already know شین. So, امشب means tonight. The word شب by itself is night. Now, here you see a new letter. This is M that we will learn in another video. امشب. Okay, now let's go to the other pair. So in all of these cases, we are working with the letter Aleph, but different varieties, different sounds that it can create. So here we have O and A. In the case of O, remember it's a short vowel. We have the example otaq, otaq. The word otaq means room in English, otaq. Now here you can see that the first letter O has appeared at the beginning of the word. So we have O, and then we have another aleph in the middle of the word, A, otaq. So you see the second aleph is the one that we will also focus on next. You can see that there is no hat because it has appeared in the middle of the word. Now here we have an example for the word, basically the letter aleph with the hat, which is a, and the word is ab. Again, a, ab. The hat appears because a is the first letter. As you can see, the other A did not have a hat because it was in the middle of the word. So, I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for more videos. You're learning fast.